So we're here at the beautiful Ocean Tank and I'm joined by Beth, who is the conservation coordinator here at Sea Life London. So Beth, what goes on here to help the sharks?
So loads of things go on here to help the sharks. What we really aim to do is educate the guests that come into the aquarium, not just about the really fun facts about the animals, but actually about the threats that they face and those conservation actions that you can take to help those species out in the wild. So a lot of it is through direct education, through schools coming in, teaching them, through talks that we have on site which talk about those issues, and the signage that we have around the aquarium as well, which then further adds to those messages and gives people that extra information that they might need. Aside from that, we have a range of different events that we run on site as well. We'll have designated weeks like a shark week or a day or two to support those really important days to focus on key animals like the sharks. We'll do extra fundraising, we'll highlight even more messages, play some fun games as well, and really add to people's journey through the aquarium. And then a few more kind of events for adults as well. We've recently started a series of events called Aquanights, which aims at the adult market. It's after hours, things like drawing classes, photography classes, film screenings, all different things to help people both fundraise and highlight those messages as well.
Brilliant. So that's what goes on sort of here in London. And then how about the bigger picture? What's going on there?
So with the bigger picture, we work really closely with a charity called the Sea Life Trust. They are partnered with all of the sea life sites, not just in the UK, but across the world. And we get our direction with regards to conservation from those guys there. They also work with a range of charities, the Marine Conservation Society, the Shark Trust, other names that do protect species like the sharks. And they'll actually hold a range of projects that we then get involved in ourselves. So just last year, we gained thousands and thousands of signatures for a petition which wanted the government to increase the amount of marine conservation zones, particularly around the UK. And they had wider projects worldwide as well. And that's going to directly affect species like the sharks and give them more of a home that is free from threats of things like fishermen and other problems out there. So we work closely with those guys and they'll give us that direction. And they work with us.
Brilliant. And then bringing it back to the UK, what can people do to help the sharks themselves? Or is there anything they can do?
There's a lot of things that people can do, and really easy things that people can do as well. It's even taking the time to go down to your local beach and having a look at what's going on down there. We regularly, across the world, do different beach cleans. We go and actually pick up litter from across the different beaches around the UK and across the world, and we'll go and take any of those items and make sure they don't actually end up in the water. They aren't eaten by the sharks and other animals, that they're actually taken and disposed of correctly. So just being more aware when you go to the beaches or even go to the parks, just to put your litter away in the appropriate manner, and also to look for signs of shark forms as well. There's a lot of information that we don't know about sharks. We already know of about 40 different species that live around the UK or visit the UK, so it's a lot more than you'd expect. And just for looking for signs of their existence, like eggs that may wash up on the beach, is a really good way to help people that work in conservation to get more of a knowledge about sharks. It's then just having more of a paying attention to shark fins, to other shark products. Oils are used in cosmetics, and jaws and teeth are illegally traded all around the world. So keeping an eye out for those shark products and not buying them is a really good way to help as well.
Brilliant. So there's a lot going on here, and there's a lot that you guys can do. To find out more, go and visit the Sea Life Trust website. And thank you very much, Beth.